Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. Thanks for clicking on the extended version of my Wedding Ringer cast interviews. You're watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. I had a chance to visit probably 10 minutes with Kevin Hart and Josh Gad, co-stars of the new film, The Wedding Ringer.
I want to propose a toast
to Happily Ever After. What exactly do you do?
Welcome to the Best Man, Inc.
I provide best man services for guys like yourself who lack in such areas.
We are so happy to be here.
There you go.
I mean, this is, you could have had these versions of us, but the real versions
you
wanted
have
to be here
yeah.
to support the film
We could
as
have
well.
Been here via satellite,
yeah.
but no, we're here live and in person. This is me, look. This is really,
this is really
I'm
Kevin.
I'm He's here. I'm He's right here. This is big.
And this is an audio animatronic version of me because I'm still in Los Angeles sleeping.
You guys have actually been all over the place doing kind of the press
yeah.
tour. I heard an interview that you called this your best work yet.
I really feel that way.
Yeah.
I feel like to date, this is my best performance. I mean, for once, I got to play a character with levels. You know, it's I've been comedic relief in a lot of my projects, which I'm fine with. But it's kind of been, you know, one note with the exception of about last night. And in this movie, I get to have several, you know.
If I do this, you need to understand that this is strictly a business relationship. You're not buying a new friend, you're hiring a best man.
Got it.
I'm assuming you made up a name for me.
Vic Mitchum.
But I wear a cape.
Hey, ladies, what's going on? My name is Vic.
I'm Vic Mitchum, and I love candy.
Vic Mitchum can have whatever he wants.
All right. I like it.
I told Josh off camera earlier, I saw you on Broadway in the Book of Mormon. It has been so much fun to watch your career.
Oh, thank
you. Know,
you.
And I know you were doing stuff before the Broadway thing, but how have you progressed, in your opinion, with your work?
I mean, it's been a crazy ride. You go from something like Book of Mormon, which was this unbelievably amazing experience and a theatrical event that is became a pop cultural event. And you're like, oh, that's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. And then unexpectedly Frozen comes along and it's like, wait, this is an even bigger, crazier thing that kids can actually go to. And Wedding Ringer's gonna put an end to all of that for me. here's the beauty about all of that is it's led to this, which I think is hands down the best movie I've done, where I'm a living person in. And I think that what makes it so amazing is, again, Kevin's performance in it is so unbelievably good that everybody who gets to go along for this crazy ride is immediately better based on what he gives you. And to a person, the entire cast in this film is an amazing discovery. It has that like Bridesmaids kind of quality to it, where you just make all of these discoveries along the way, and everybody's giving their A work. Everybody's amazing.
I know you've got two young kids. Will you let them see Kevin's stand-up at all, or do they have to get a little older to see that?
Yeah, his daughter came to
my
shows.
Daughter came to,
She's
yeah, my daughter is his biggest fan.
She, and let me tell you something about the profanity that comes out that one's mouth. At the age four, I've never seen anything like
that. I accidentally let Book of Mormon play once in the house. And that was one of the worst decisions I ever made. So next stop, we're going to do Let Me Explain
Let
and work and work our way up through Kevin's repertoire.
Phil Florin, Phil Flop.
You're getting married. Who yes. is your best man?
Who is my best man?
Yeah, Kev.
Josh, that's weird. You just she asked me a question. You just popped
tell
up.
Tell me like, who your best man is,
well,
Kev.
I'll
she asked
what,
both of us a
it's,
question.
It's not your body. Get it off my arm.
Fine,
Josh.
Go.
You know what? Because of that type of pressure, I think I'm going to probably make it my son. Which is very rare. My son is only 7 years old at the time, so he'll probably be about 8 and a half when I'm getting
married. Look, I don't think he'll be ready to handle
that
kind of pressure.
No, he will be ready. He will be ready because I'm his dad. So I think what better person to be my best man than my best man? That's the best version.
Let your son and I both have an opportunity
to
prove ourselves.
No, you can't.
That's all I'm saying.
There is no, like, there's no... There isn't a contest with you and my son.
Give us both speeches. See who can read it better, Kevin.
Wait, my son can read, Josh.
I know more words from my...
Maybe you do, but I can teach him difficult words if that's the case.
How you looking on groomsmen?
Not good at all.
Not good as in you need one or two?
I need seven.
You need seven groomsmen?
I do.
You have any idea what you're asking for? You're asking me to pull off a golden tux.
Who would you pay, because you're paid by your character,
yes.
to be at his wedding and
yes.
to get everybody else there, who would you actually pay to show up at your wedding?
Who would I pay to show up at my wedding? Well, it's funny you say that because I'm going to have to pay somebody to perform or to sing.
Yeah, I promised I told Kev I wouldn't do it for free.
Josh,
wait, somebody else?
You know who I'm probably going to end up paying? I'm a and this is, I don't want this to come off the wrong way, so you have to be careful the way you say this, who I wouldn't mind paying for their talent.
Yes.
Because I appreciate their talent and I wouldn't want to take advantage. I'm a huge Miguel fan, and I think he has some songs that that kind of, you know, that put me in a place where me and my lady have moments to some of his music.
Did we just learn that Miguel is playing
Kevin
Hart's
disgusting music. I'm saying that's somebody that I wouldn't mind. She asked a question. Yeah. But having Miguel sing a song that me and my lady refer to when we talk about love would be something nice.
Well, Miguel's singing at my daughter's bat mitzvah. So.
No, that's not true.
But
that's
that ain't
not true.
And smoke it.
That's not, no, that's not. Josh, this is.
Miguel gets my daughter in touch with her Judaism.
That's ridiculous.
Yes, Kevin.
No, Miguel and Judaism does not go together.
Yes, it does.
That's ridiculous.
Come on, let's go. I'm teaching some bass.
I'm not dancing.
It is my job to make you look good on your wedding day. Now, I need you to get comfortable with being uncomfortable. Come on.
12 years of dance lessons. My mom said one day they'd come in handy.
You've been asked to dance. I know Ellen had to dance. Everybody's had to dance. I just want to not look like an idiot at a club or at a dance.
Right.
I don't need you guys to be elaborate, but can you give me something? I can't do all this,
no.
But just something.
I do wedding dances. Kevin does club dances.
No,
Kevin,
I don't.
Yeah,
if I'm
there
just
you go. Pop, stop, and drop. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't do anything special.
Kevin, Kevin has no cartilage in his shoulders.
I just know how to jerk certain parts of my
This is called the I have no cartilage dance. And I do more of the traditional.
No,
oh,
Josh,
wow.
Don't.
Yeah.
Josh, why are you. Don't go to ballet.
What is that?
He's, Josh is
the guy.
No, Josh, don't. There's nothing in here to support that. Jump, Josh, don't.
I need your help.
This is strictly a business relationship. You're not buying a new friend, you're hiring a best man.
Thank you. Thank
Yo,
you.
What you doing? Yo, what you doing?
Sorry, I got really excited.
Some of the funniest people I have ever hung with, Kevin Hart and Josh Gad, The Wedding Ringer in theaters. And don't forget to get your hands on one of these beautiful Harkins Theaters loyalty cups, brand new for 2015. And don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for all of your movie news, promotions, and giveaways.